Hello everyone, welcome to Four Sides with Pianchri. Here's the top news for the day. Mamata Banerjee puts forth her condition for Congress alliance. LinkedIn comes under fire for blocking a young CEO. Grammy winner and singer Falguni writes song along with Prime Minister Narendra Modi. Prabhas film Adipurush gains a lot of negative publicity, yet with record collection on day one, it is the largest pan-India film so far in 2023. Who will Mamata Banerjee befriend for the general elections next year? Ahead of Panchayat Raj elections in West Bengal, Mamata Di puts forward her terms in case Congress wants to form an alliance with Trinamool Congress. At a time when aggressive steps to come together to fight BJP and Congress, and few others are looking at forming alliances with either of the parties for the 2024 Lok Sabha election, all eyes in West Bengal and at the centre are on Mamata Di. The Chief Minister of West Bengal and the fiery leader of the Trinamool Congress Party on one said she could be open to consider alliance with Congress Party, but it comes with conditions. In the upcoming Panchayat Raj elections, Congress is fighting alongside the CPI Party, making it one of the competitions in the triangular fight where Trinamool Congress will be fighting Communist Party and BJP. In such a scenario, Mamata Banerjee made it clear that unless the Congress Party stops supporting BJP and Communist Party, there is no way she can consider an alliance with the National Congress Party for the upcoming Lok Sabha elections. She spoke at a rally ahead of the state panchayat elections on 8 July when she launched an attack on Congress for joining hands with the BJP in the state against her party. "You have ruled many states, Congress. You are CBI's biggest friend. Also, the BJP is here. Yet you want us support in parliament. We will support you against the BJP, but do not come to us for help in Bengal after living with CPI here," she said. There is still time for the Lok Sabha elections. Whether Mamata Di will reconsider her stance in greater interest, one can only wait and watch. As the number of child prodigies in the world of business is increasing and we get to see the youngest of CEO making their name and fame with their innovative ideas, shouldn't the professional networks like LinkedIn acknowledge them? Here's what happened in the case of a 15-year-old CEO. His name is Eric Zhu. He completed his school education and became the youngest co-founder and CEO of Aviato, a startup that makes sourcing easier for venture funds. At a time when kids were playing and attending classes in school, Eric would be sitting in his school bathroom trying to balance his business venture with his classes. His loo breaks would actually be investor meetings. According to an article in Live Mint, this young startup owner has earned $100K of funding in 2 weeks. While he is managing employees who are older than him in age, he is quite popular in the investor world and on social media. He is an inspiration for many for creating a great success story and doing all this while balancing his school. And when he is blocked from using one of the top professional networks, LinkedIn, it had upset not just him but all his followers as well. The reason is simple. According to LinkedIn rules, the minimum age to have a profile is 16, and even though the 15-year-old have a great track record in handling his business, he is found to be ineligible for LinkedIn. Similar situation arose when 14-year-old software employee at SpaceX was unable to create his profile on LinkedIn. Followers are increasingly demanding for LinkedIn to change its terms. The Millet Song, inspired by Prime Minister and his pre-position speech at UN to declare 2023 as International Year of Millets, is launched. Mumbai-born singer and songwriter Falguni penned the lyrics in collaboration with PM Modi and sings it with her husband Gaurav Shah. It was Prime Minister Narendra Modi's proposal on the healthy grains, the indigenous millets, also known as Sri Anna, that led to a resolution designating 2023 as the International Year of Millets. This was after it was endorsed by the members of the UN's Food and Agriculture Organization governing bodies as well as by the 75th session of the UN General Assembly. Falguni, who received the Grammy Award for Best Children's Album in 2022 for her album A Colorful World, wrote a song in millets inspired by PM Modi's speech and released the album along with her husband. She wrote the millet song in collaboration with the Prime Minister, which adds to the song's prominence. Falu admitted that she naively asked the Prime Minister if he could write the song with her and he agreed. "We have collaborated on the song. It's a single and it's coming out on June 16 with a worldwide release on every streaming platform," she said in a statement in her website. "It's one thing to write for him and it's one thing to write with him. In the middle of the song, you will hear the speech that he has written and narrated in his own voice."
इस अभियान की अगुवाई कर रहा है।
It is a lifetime opportunity for any artist, she added. Narendra Modi retweeted the link to the song, appreciating Falu's effort. Despite trolls, Adipurush earns 140 crores across the world and stands as the biggest pan-India opener in 2023. But what are these trolls? What is the reason the film is attracting negative response? The film Adipurush, directed by Om Rao, with 600 crore invested in it, was one of the most awaited films in recent times. Yet when it released, the film attracted mixed response and a lot of trolls. The audience who walked away not so happy had issues with the casual depiction of Rama's story. Depiction of Shiva Bhakt Ravana has been an issue from the time the trailer released. Now the noise over his portrayal only increased. One of the criticisms was over the graphics and that they were not up to the standards. The film that concentrated on the war scenes fell short of the emotional connect one would accept in a film that is supposed to be about devotion and spiritual feeling. There is a reason for such expectations. The entire promotions of Adipurush were around attracting the devout and about how the audience would be immersed in the devotional fervor. However, the movie is reimagination of Ramayana's war episode and the director took the liberty of portraying the characters and simplifying the language. This is not going down well with the audience who came looking for an upgraded version of their image of Lord Rama from the other versions of epic that they watched until now. That said, Adipurush, high on visuals and action sequences, lacks in emotional connect and humor that are the lifeline of Indian cinema. However, despite the criticism and trolls online, the filmmakers are a happy a lot. The film is doing well in the theaters. If the first day collections are anything to go by, globally the film collected around 140 crores and makers claim it is the largest pan-India film this year. Whether this will transcend to the next few weeks will have to be seen.
Thank you for watching Foresights with me, Anjali. See you all again with latest updates.